In times of nature's wrath, instincts kick in. Even the cat knows that there's something going on. Estee's mother knows the signs, a flood warning. She tells Estee to change her clothes and get her emergency bag. They must evacuate, and they must do it swiftly before they end up gasping for air under the waters. Thankfully, the family is prepared. But what did they do? In today's episode of How to Survive the Science Way, you'll learn what to do when the waters around you start rising. Thousands, if not millions of people experience flood. It's a worldwide phenomena that we need to prepare for. Let's see how to survive a flood the science way. Do you live in an area that is often flooded? What should you do? It can happen due to so many things. Flooding is usually caused by heavy rainfall that accumulates much faster than how fast the soil can absorb it, or when rivers cannot keep up with the heavy rainfall. No one can ever be fully ready when natural disasters happen, but we can equip our minds with enough knowledge to think clearly when put under pressure and danger during these times. First, know if your area is often flooded. Research or ask local authorities and neighbors. You can also protect your house by putting a barrier to prevent flood water from entering your home. Take sandbags as an example. Be ready once a storm alert is sent through your phone. Or listen to the radio after knowing about possible flood in your area. And if possible, sign up for flood insurance. Pack an emergency bag that you can just grab when evacuating. It should contain at least 3 days of food and water supplies. Bring a whistle, flashlight, radio, and batteries. It is also much better to have solar-powered chargers to avoid losing contact with everyone in case your battery runs out. A first aid kit and medications will also come in handy in unexpected situations. You should also pack some clothes and a hygiene kit. The important documents should also be kept dry, so taking them with you is best. When packing these things, always think about the whole family. Do not leave your pets out of the picture. If there is already a flash flood, evacuate. And if help is yet to come, go to higher ground, but avoid places you can get trapped in. Switch off all utilities, disconnect appliances, and avoid plugging something in sockets to prevent electrocution. Stay away from running water, even if the help takes a long time. Stay on high ground and shout for help. If walking on water is the last resort, make sure to use a long stick or a rope so as not to lose your balance. If possible, choose paths less submerged. And if you're driving, avoid crossing rivers and bridges. While staying put, ensure only to eat and drink clean food and water to avoid infections and diseases. Do not be hasty. Listen to after-flood news reports in any way you can. If you are already in an evacuation area, return home only when advised. If possible, return home during the daytime. If on a higher ground of your house, come down safely and avoid the remaining running water, which may be contaminated and charged with electricity. For any damage inside your house, call a service company to prevent health hazards. While waiting, you can dry and disinfect everything in your house that was submerged underwater. Though all will be well when prepared, we can also do something to prevent floods from happening in the first place by taking care of nature. First, avoid illegal logging. Avoid constructions and waterways. And lastly, be vigilant in proper waste disposal. Remember, there is no planet B, and we are only inhabitants of Earth, not its owners. We should take care of our nature so we do not have to pay the price of letting it take back our lives. For more survival tips like this, subscribe to Science Times, like this video, and tell us what you learned below. See you in the next episode of How to Survive the Science Way.